All right. So, there's actually somebody else you can fight later in the game that I didn't know about. Until just looking at the community tab and was like, what's different about 1.0? Oh, they did actually legitimately add... Basically, think Slay the Spire. You do some quests, and then you unlock an additional thing after you kill the one boss. I did reach this said prince, but he's so fucking overpowered, I don't know. The deck I had was no good against it. Like, nothing. I had a good bleed deck with a weasel, wolf, and bear. But I'm almost thinking maybe you don't even want more party members. It might condense the deck just enough. I'm wondering if two bears could do it. Honestly, bear and wolf, I think they might be able to synergize. Now, do I really want to take any oaths with me? Wait, there's different tiers? Oh, only for some of them. You know, bleed on a bear. Except I'd have no way of healing. Hey, Lady Bunny. If we had it that the enemies just caused bleed, the bears could get rid of it and gain armor. But then I'd have to try two bears. Nah, I'm just gonna go with this. Okay, hit points. The problem with Modify Your Deck is all it does is let you duplicate a card. And technically, I think the less cards I have, the better for trying to beat the prince, but I don't even know what kind of deck I need. The last run, because I didn't know how badass the prince was, I went with Bleed. And it worked great until we got to the last boss. Then he just decimated me because I had no cards that could give me armor. Yeah, let's take a random upgrade gem. What does this do? Plus one stamina cost, but you're able to draw three cards. I'm doing all right. Now, don't let my mood from this morning... Just because I played a game that made me, like, madder than all heck. I'm doing alright. The plus one stamina cost, though. See, that's the other problem with the final boss. He has it that all your cards cost more. This game is a bit frustrating. You're right. Being able to draw three cards. All right, let me think. I mean, okay, this would make momentum cost 1 point. We would discard a card and then draw three. So, sure. I mean, one thing about the final boss is I don't have all these guys leveled up all the way, so that could also play in a factor. Maybe they have some really good skill that I've have yet to unlock. More damp. Honestly, second wins are nice, but I gotta try to not take as many cards. I feel like I'm okay. Now, here was the thing that I didn't pay attention because, I had to look at what was different about 1.0. So basically, they add in this informant guy. Is the quest always the same? Yes, yeah, so we gotta pick the boat event and buy a boat, and then we can proceed, and then we gotta like rescue somebody in the prison and then help them escape in order to try to even fight the prince. I mean, one thing this I feel like this game is lacking is able to modify your deck. But then again, that's probably just because I play too much Grifflands, and you can just break the game easily by getting rid of all your cards. Like, if you could get these events more often. You misheard me, something awful. Hopefully, it wasn't too bad. Ah, yes. Probably because of the word deck. Probably sounds like something else. I should have played Vanguard first. You have that kind of mind? That's okay. Fury's gonna be a problem. We need to find some equipment real quick. Well, let's see. You could do the second wind, and then you can do this. Get the stamina refunded. And then you can up your defense. You would bleed. See, remove all winded. I could never find a very good use for that. Okay, apply 15 armor to an ally. Active character and the ally both gain winded. Great. So, there's the synergy, huh? right. Discard up to a card and convert bleed to restoration. See, deal 6 damage and apply 2 vulnerable. Every time this card is played, damage is increased by 2 permanently. I guess if you could play it a whole bunch of times in a battle. Doesn't get banished. You know what? Sounds good. Let's try Oathkeeper. We're going to have to, like, make sure we use that a lot. Okay, and you need Fortress. Okay, let's put the wolf in the back. Okay, weapons cache or intelligence? Well, if I take the weapons cache, I could maybe try. We'd have an elite fight. I mean, you don't have to take the elite fight. But maybe I want. Oh, there wasn't a fight this time. Usually, if you want all this stuff, there's a fight. Take that for now. Alright, we'll take the hidden gems. Okay, +1 stamina cost. Party heals 3. The last thing I need is things to cost more, though. Now, can you? Okay, what one had the gem? Can you, like, remove gems? Because drag cards onto slot to extract the token. Where's momentum? I don't think it's on here. So I was wondering if you could put, like, multiple. I guess once as you've put the thing on, gain 3 health for what? Heck. So if I don't want it on, or no, I think it's just, wait. There you go. So if you want to take them off, you do that. Okay. So you're not, like, forced to keep them if you don't like what they are, which is kind of nice. Yeah, we'll just take the money and hope that we get a battle. Honestly, I think we want battles. Because we want to just, you know, take advantage of the Oathkeeper. I mean, I can kind of heal up. As long as these guys can't, like, you know, apply bleed. So honestly, what I could do is just be like, the only card that we want is Oathkeeper, and we're just gonna try to upgrade it as much as possible. Ah, of course they can do bleed. Well, that's okay, we can... We can maybe use Oath and, Bleed's taken care of. Who actually did that? It was you. Now, you actually can't afford to use Fortress because of your winded state. I mean, we're going to be here a while. But it might be worth it. Because these guys shouldn't be able to really get through the bear. And I can heal by 3 hit points if I have to. Unless, of course, I draw both cards on the same turn. I mean, once as we have more stamina, it'll work a little bit easier. See, because we have the one oath where it's like if I don't play them, they get banished. Now we just have 2 cards. So now I'm guaranteed to just sit here and play the thing I want. No, I'm not going to take any cards for a minute. Search party, search party, or search party. Okay, now the spear guys can could attack through. Yeah, whatever. Nah, just in case, we need to play the shield. There, you can at least play. Actually, you can play both of them. Yeah, this is already paying off. A brace would be nice. Actually, I'll take upper hand. Okay, here's the boat merchant. I can take it next turn. Who's getting stamina? The wolf? Actually, that's kind of good. He needs it. Alright, so we take the boat. So we need to arrange a boat to be sent to the royal court. I was hoping that you'd get Fortress this turn. Won't be able to use it when you get it now. Chance to... No, that just gives you an item. There, we'll just take on the heavy patrol. More enemies for me to murder. I just think if we had the Bloodlust where he could, you know, get 3 HP for every enemy he kills, because he's going to be killing a lot of enemies. Let's see, what do we have? Target has armor, double damage. Club. Applies vulnerability. Honestly, I probably should give you just a one-handed weapon. And then try to find you a shield. Alright, buddy. What do we get? Whenever this character plays a talent, one random card in your hand becomes zero stamina. Whenever this character forcefully moves an enemy, no. Whenever you discard, spawn a flourish. Too bad it costs a point. Honestly, we might as well just take flow. Because this is a talent. Ooh. This is some possibilities here. Because, wait a minute. If all you had was like a few cards, and you still had momentum, maybe momentum could be free? Maybe I should give the bear the shield as well. You need more stamina. Alright, what do you get? The start of their turn, if this character has any will, they draw a card. Or whenever you play a talent. Whenever this character plays a talent, one random card in your hand becomes zero. Actually, you know what? Yes. Yeah, I think the bear should probably have the shield, because I'm sure the mace is a one-handed weapon. Honestly, the last thing we want to do is buy cards. How about get rid of cards? I mean, even though they cost zero, we don't want to use them right now. Because we want to save all the points on just murdering them with the Oath card. Wait. It stays zero the whole time? I mean, I guess until you end turn, but that means if I could, you know, constantly just draw cards. Like, this is zero now, so if I do this... I made a mistake. Well, wait. I have to pay attention to my stamina, though. Otherwise, that fight would be impossible to win at that point. Make sure we don't draw the card if I can't play it. Also, the battle changed? There's less enemies now. Interesting. I don't know if I necessarily want that. The more enemies, the more damage it does. Could you imagine if it actually picked this to be free? Honestly, I don't think we want to take any other cards. Let's see, what can the wolf do for me? What kind of provisions? Can he get rid of a card? I'll click on him. What can you do for me? Oh no, you just give me cards. I want to get rid of cards. Never mind. see. I hope I didn't miss. No, I think we're fine. I think it's the next one where we have to do something for the quest. Okay, this guy's kind of annoying. Honestly, I think I'm going to have to play some cards to get rid of these barriers. See, that way at least a guy moves up so they don't all get to go at once. Now, the bear can get rid of the poison. The wolf, on the other hand, cannot. Oh, right. Taking cover. Well, fine. I wonder if, let's see, every time this card is played, yeah, so you could destroy the barrier and it would still give you stuff. So I guess go for it. Is there a reason you can't? Oh, because I'm not on the wolf. As long as I keep your armor up, the poison, at least the poison gets rid of your armor and not, like, bleed where it would not give a crap about that. So he basically just took no damage again. You know what? Yes, I'll take that particular guard. Alright, let's see here. Earn you combat with 10, gain a stamina. I think that's what you have. Okay, well, we're fully healed, and we got plenty of money, because I'm not buying anything. So we might as well just level up a character. I'm almost thinking, let's just get the wolf up. I wonder. A second one? You know what? Sure, we'll probably have to increase its damage somehow, but it is another talent. This could actually work, because I could just level up the small one on this fight. I kind of want to delete this bear, though. Okay, if I'm gonna kill the bear, I might as well use the Oathbreaker that does million damage if, you know, we'll... Well, here, I'm gonna wait till I get the one that's just gonna decimate him. As much as I'd like to use that, if the next card happens to be the Oathbreaker, I won't be able to play it. And then I'd be sad. Okay, the one we want to play is the cheap one. Though this one's now free. Nah, screw it. We need them to both to get badass, so... Now, I can get rid of cards here. I think I can get rid of two cards in the fire. Though, I just got thinking the Warden's going to be basically the guy I won't be able to kill, because if you do too much damage to him per turn, well, I'll just have to try to keep, like, something that can do damage, and then it won't matter. Maybe I'll just try to get the other one upgraded. We'll let that Oathbreaker go. That way I can try to get the other one up to about 30 or 40 damage. Hera, what other talent can we get, friend? Whenever this character plays a card costing will or uses their ability, they gain 10 vitality. So, at the start of their turn, all stacks of bleed on this character are converted to vitality and removed. Well, that'd be a way to get rid of bleed. Whenever this character plays a card costing... Okay, well, will abilities? No. I might as well just take... The start of their turn, all stacks of bleed on this character are converted to vitality and removed. That sounds like a plan. Honestly, stamina. Just take stamina. Ambush, ambush, or ambush. I mean, I hate to say, friends, I think the joke might be on you. Now, the thing about this small shield is, the take cover thing's actually a talent. So, whenever we play a talent, something becomes zero. So, that's actually kind of interesting. Don't play that one first. Hold on. Honestly, I don't think we want to be... I'm not even going to look at the cards, because I'm probably not going to take any. Whenever he plays a card, he can do poison. You know, that... Yeah, that could work. Sure. We'll fight the elite combat. Here, just play kick so that way we'll keep it. Yeah, the wolf take a little bit of damage this turn, but at least we do have that gem that can heal, so it's not a huge issue. Well, if you're going to attack anybody with poison, the bear would be the one to go. I can just get rid of it. You're gonna poison him this time, huh? As long as I keep his armor up high enough, it won't matter. Take a lot of poison, but that's okay. Basically, we'll just play this, and then play this, and then he basically all the way healed. Let's see. At turn end, if this character has no armor, they gain 35 armor, but they get a winded. I mean, not that that's that big of a deal. Though the extra stamina is kind of nice. See, if he has no armor, he would gain 35. Can't I do an elite fight? Nope. I wanted to do an elite fight with that. Seems like the more combats we do, the better. I mean, it's taking forever, but hey. These Oathbreakers are starting to do some major damage now. I don't suppose you can do the net on him. He's the one who's going to be attacking. Too bad they couldn't. I mean, if I knew... Too bad you can't quit and change the formation. Put him up front and have him get netted. That way his Oathbreaker would do less damage. Though it's getting to the point where it's like it wouldn't matter. You'd still one-shot him. He's gonna die to poison anyway, but whatever. Thank you. Maybe I should be looking for some more cards. I need some cards that would allow me to draw. I should get rid of your poison. Another Oathbreaker? Sure. Why not? Oathbreakers for days. All right, you see, gain the Lucky Charm. Remove a card from your deck and gain a random upgrade token. Okay. Minus one will cost. Well, the only thing that we have would be the thing that would allow me to move around. We needed to draw a card one. Okay, prisoners. We're going to have to do that next turn. Would it also duplicate the gem? I believe it would. So maybe two momentums? Because if you could get him to be free. I think there's potential here to have infinite turns. All right, we got to do the prisoners. Say 66. And we'll hit you. Because you're not gonna die. The gem does not get copied. Now, if I'd have known that, I would have picked the draw card one. Well, now we know. Yeah. Unfortunately, you're gonna die before I can get another oath thing on you. Oh, wait, no, no, you're not, because you're on the front row. Now I'll upgrade the other Oathbreaker for a bit. So we had to find another combat, but that's fine. Because we're pretty much at the point where I can just delete everybody. Thank you. I mean, bleed isn't going to be that big of an issue. I guess in the sense, you know, I can just heal it anyway. Ah, that's the thing that makes it that your armor can't go above 120. I know there were battles where I was like, how come it stops at 120? That's why, because this guy's a jerk. I don't have any will points to fix that. Man, you just have to take some damage, I guess. It's fine. I mean, sometimes, yes, they do have more health. so early, it'd be like, yes, I could draw an extra card. Okay, we're gonna need these chains eventually, so... I mean, they'll kind of be in the way, but we do need them. Provoked by what? Thank you. Let's see. Do we have anything that'll allow me to draw a card? No. I'm not sure. What's this guy? Whenever this character breaks an opponent's armor, die hard. At the end of their turn, all bleeding on this character is removed and converted to charge. Alright, so you don't want to be doing bleed. Luckily, we're not using a bleed deck. I probably could just outright delete you, but nah. I might as well get these Oathbreaker cards up. Oathkeeper, Oathbreaker, whatever they're called. They should be called Oath Power, so that way they're OP for short. Trying to get our wolf, huh? Trying to get our wolf buddy. Well, he could just... Like, nope. Why didn't that work? Hey, you could switch places. Well, whatever. Shall be it. Alright, now what can you get? Whenever this character deals damage, apply one bleed. Start on every turn, you may discard one card to draw two. Alright, you know what? Yes, I'll take that. I'll do the one that's going to do the most damage. Guarded treasure. Sure. Guarded treasure, because I think we can do an elite fight. Let's see, who to just outright delete. Get rid of the bear first. Duh, bears. Did he hit his own guys? I don't even know what happened there. Kind of looked like that's what happened. Let's see here. Actually, no, do that. And then do this. And then I guess delete this guy. All right, now what can we get here? I wonder, does that stack with the other one? Let's see. Once per turn, when your hand sight reaches zero, draw one card for every ally on this character's rank with stamina remaining. Everyone on this character's rank starts with one inspiration. All right, but it's only once per turn. Here, just take the gambler. I'll see if it actually stacks or not. Gain 3 random upgrade tokens. Yeah, this could be good because, oh yes, draw 3 cards. Just what I wanted to see. Now let me think about this. Even if I had to discard a card, it would allow me to draw 3. Actually, I think I'll just put on a shield. Nice, I can discard two cards. It's kind of nice, because then we might actually just get right off the bat, find the, an Oathbreaker. Which will just instantly delete an enemy. Now, wait a minute. Doesn't the Juggernaut, whenever this character receives damage, oh, five or less. That would do some... Nah, I'm not going to worry about it. I'd like to be able to get rid of maybe a few more cards. And of course, I didn't get lucky enough to. Oh, you're going to be able to hit him, huh? Well, okay. Well, I did. Well, hold on. There, that'll. Well, not really. That kind of helps, but at the same time, I kind of messed up, and I need to try again. This is why it'd be nice if I could just get rid of like one or two more cards. Oh, I still did that wrong. I need to do challenge for... I hate it. You do one thing wrong. Luckily, you can reset it. I know that's cheating, but I don't care. Okay. Do fortress. But you challenge this guy's armor. Then you do that. Then you do this. And then this way we should have enough defense that I won't take any damage. Well, you might take some damage, but... Oh, you're still pacified? I should have worn off. Move, swap them to another position. I guess you can't... Yeah, just switch to there then. I could kick him just to try to get a little bit of extra health for the bear. Whatever. how you moved him. That ruins his fortress. Ah, that's why he has... If he gets moved, he gets pacifist. That's the problem. Hey. Jerk. Stop that. Oh, that's right. Anytime you draw a card, that's going to happen. So be it. Okay, jerk off. Did you have your fun? Because I think I'm going to murder you now. Well, I mean, we don't really need to be healed, so... Oh no, the task force! I think they're in for a rude awakening. Just a hunch. Just instant death. we don't need... I wonder, can you win with... Can you just not have a weapon? I'm wondering... Hold on. No, you have to have a weapon equipped. Okay. I was kind of hoping you didn't have to. Just, you know, get rid of yet another card. Yeah, they're gonna... Oh, hold on. I'll save you a little bit of health. Thing is, he can gain it back pretty easily. Well, that wasn't very useful. Thank you. Hey, now the deck's getting to be at the point where it's pretty broke. I can just make all these cards be free. You know, as long as they actually pick said cards. Let's see who leveled up. Nope, not you. You did. Well, we probably don't want. Discard one card, has no armor. Discard up to one card, convert allies' bleed to restoration. Start every turn. Nope, forfeit. We don't want it. And you know what? Sure, take a will point. Okay, well, we can at least get rid of one card. I think I'm good on the chains. How many do we have? Don't we have two of them? That's enough. Let's see, they're just gonna attack him. Come on, where's an oath break? Where's an Oath Keeper when I need one? Honestly, get rid of the poison. Get rid of Poison Mouse. Alright. Any of these other cards? So you don't have any other ways to draw any more cards? Well, yes. Thank you. So long, buddy. Just keep drawing cards. Till you can't draw no more. I had momentum, idiot. Oh well, it doesn't matter. He's dead this turn. We should have enough Oath Keepers that it's just GG. Alright, hit him with the weakest one. And then follow up with the strongest one. The task force again, huh? You think the task force would look at us and go, nope, we didn't see a damn thing. Alright, play this first. Then technically this is free. Though, however, why don't we do this first? Deal weapon damage X times for every stack of winded this character has, but it gets banished. Nah, let's not forfeit. The less cards, the better. Ooh, I could get rid of... Let's see, I don't care. Take some damage. All right, there's the escape, and we can do the combat first and then do the escape. I think. And do you think they'd put something here that would just fuck me over? I guess they technically could. Oh, we're at max level anyway. So you know what? Let's just do the escape. All right. This is where we got to use our chains. Now, this is one of those fights that's technically forever, but unless I had a way to make sure that I didn't banish the chain, it wouldn't really help now, would it? Have any room to actually draw a card. Of course it doesn't matter. GG. And luckily now all the chains are gone. Thank you. Oh, yeah, that's the problem. You move him around, and then now he can't do anything. Well, whatever. He probably doesn't need to do anything. I still have one left, right? Okay. That's all I need. See, I don't think you're going to have anything I want, so, I mean, it's too bad you can't, like, you know, pay money to get rid of a card. Alright, now, this guy could be technically a problem. Let me see here. Actually, I need to take a quick bathroom break. Hold on. No, I need you. Okay. This character gains 100 while this character is above 60. All stacks of bleed. Okay, no, that's not the thing. Whenever this character takes more than 25 damage from a single attack, the excess damage is ignored and converted to armor. Well, technically, that would let me do Oathbreaker a lot, so maybe this will work. This could be great. But anyway, be right back. One thing I kind of hope is that poison doesn't fuck it up, because the bear could poison name. Well, we're gonna... Okay, hold on. Okay, this gets banished, but... First card gets banished, so this is the card we're gonna use first. Well, I didn't really get anything decent, did I? No, you're fine. I guess you're gonna have to use the fortress then. Ah, fuck. Okay, maybe I better not use Fortress then, because if I can't actually play any cards this turn, I'm gonna be screwed. I was kind of hoping that you would kill him, because I kind of wanted to kick the warden back. You got like 7 winded, so there's nothing you can do. Well, I could have this get... Well, hold on. I could just lose challenge. He's going to gain armor when I do that, but maybe I can get my Oathkeepers to be, like, super badass. Let's see if I can just keep... If we can somehow just, you know, infinite turn it, I won't really worry about it. Though he can do, he does something where it's like, he does damage based on his armor stat. Right. But I'm not worried about that at the moment. I think I can get infinite turns at this point. And then I can get these Oathkeepers to be super strong for the last fights. Because I can try to whittle him down with the falchion. No, wait. He's got... That wasn't at zero? Are they resetting? No, they're not resetting, are they? No, they're still at zero. Okay, we're gonna be here a while. I just want these Oathkeepers to do massive damage. And then we'll just try to whittle him down. I don't know if poison damage would work, because every time the bear plays a card, poison would have take effect, but is that part of damage? That could be bad. Whenever this character takes more than 25 damage from a single attack, is poison considered an attack or not? That I don't know. Though, being that I can just hit him with the falchion, I can eventually kill him. I know, we're gonna be here, like, all frickin' day. We'll at least get this one to 200. Well, we happened to got the... We got some... gems that allowed us to do this, otherwise this wouldn't really be working. That, and we have the, whenever you play a talent, flow. Whenever this character plays a talent, one random card in your hand becomes zero stamina this turn. So, yeah. We found a way to break the game. So I might try to get this Oathkeeper up to 200 damage. Even if this is going to take like half an hour. Then again, this might be good enough. The prince is pretty damn overpowered, though, so I don't know. I mean, if I can survive long enough to just get free turns. Feels like a, is that Slay the Spire? Yeah. Yeah, I have that game, but that, man, I'm not very good at that one. I do remember some infinite turn decks, though, that were kind of fun. Okay, you know what? That's probably good enough. This does 210. So, let's try to get... Though I have to hope that I get momentum, because the only other thing that can draw cards is Oathkeeper, and as soon as I hit you with that, you just gain million armor again. I guess I'll have no choice. Yeah, we could use the dagger. That might not be a bad idea. I mean, if I have to, I'll just use the Oathkeeper to draw cards. Because at least he's gaining vulnerability this way. Let's see, yeah, that was the problem. Why I didn't really want to... Because then the more cards you use, then it's like, well, now you got to try to draw it. Eh, boy, this is going to be fun. Well, I need to be able to draw cards here. Might have to end turn just to have some of these Oathbreakers get destroyed. For this guy, I really needed to have it that I drew extra cards with one of these. I'm really hoping that he can take damage from the poison. That way, if I do have to end turn, because he's just doing battle cry, so... like I'm gonna like get murdered. Maybe if I do this a certain way. Yeah, so many freaking cards played. Okay, this might be the solution here. If I play these first, then we should draw you. And then... I don't have to use the Oathbreaker. There's gonna be so many cards played on this battle alone, it'd be ridiculous. Look at all this poison he's got. Well, 3 hours later, we might be, might win. Can I in turn just get rid of the Oath Keepers? N- if these are in my hand, no. I think we're stuck doing this. Because I kind of need momentum, and as soon as I play momentum, the cards just come back. So I think I have no choice but to just keep doing this. Just because of what, you know, oath I took. Yeah, I know. Fun, fun, fun. I mean, he's down to 715 armor now. Now finally below 400. Trapped in a time loop until you hit him for a few hundred times. Yeah. Yep. All the while he's getting more and more poisoned. Cards played. I feel like it should be an achievement. Now finally below 100. Thank you. Now we're gonna finally start doing some damage. I mean, I'd end turn, but I don't know if the poison would actually kill him. I mean, I think it would. Unless they consider poison an attack. And he'd just gain armor instead, so I'm not going to take the chance. Yeah, exactly. Wouldn't be a good idea to try to science it out now. Now when two more hits and he's gonna be dead. You emerged victorious after 7 rounds. Yeah, you only played 400 cards. Or more. $435. GG. Sorry, Shadow Master, you don't have much of a chance. All right, here we go. The only problem is everything's going to cost more. Instant victories are so nice. All right. Let me think about this. Alright, you know what? Draw a card. Okay, another second wind. Let's play it. And then... what should I try to erase first? Alright, all cards cost an additional one stamina. That was just my normal momentum, that's right. It wasn't the one that would allow me to draw more cards. Okay, kick doesn't help here. As long as you don't die, I don't really care, though. Moving you means you can't do anything now. Well, I mean, I have no choice, because he can't do anything. And the nice thing about this is considered a talent, so something's gonna cost zero. What's the next card? Yeah, no. End turn. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to play it. Yeah, whenever he gets hit by bleed, he just automatically gets rid of it. All right, Prince, I think it's time to say goodbye. GG. The prince lay slouched against the base of the throne, clutching his wounds. So does Landon plan to bury my city too, or conquer it? You don't respond. Our houses have warned for far too long. He spit, still managing to draw breath. So many years of bloodshed. My father dreamt of peace, but could never see a means to it. It brought him great sadness and longing, so I vowed it would be my legacy. I would bring us peace, make my father proud. But then Landon came back to Blackchurch. My father began to regain hope. He'd said the great Landon was a leader with whom we could broker a peace. He spoke with such admiration and love, love he never directed at his son, for a man he had never met. His voice takes a darker tone. So I burned your black church to the ground until the sky went black, until you couldn't breathe through the ash. When I returned from that victory, I did not see pride in his eyes. No, he wouldn't even meet my gaze. Ruin, he kept saying, as if in a trance. You've brought ruin and nothing more. He foresaw all this, that Landon would come for me. That you would all come for me. Yeah, you know, two of us. He had daddy issues. He noted more virtues and qualities of your people that night than he had ever mentioned of me. I couldn't bear to hear it, so I did what I did. Then I was rewarded for my sins, of course. A festival held in his honor. The bitter irony of it. Even now, out there in the streets, they celebrate his name. They sing songs of the noble king. The just king. Virtues I do not possess. They love my father, but they will never love me. A strange stillness washes over him. So, what will it be? He continues after a long pause. What fate awaits me? Oh, let's see. Hang his head from the city walls. Hand him over to the people. You know what? Let the people decide. He looks up at you, eyes full of dread as the gravity of your verdict begins to dawn on him. I see, he mutters in a low, broken voice. You lead him out through the gatehouse. The city bell rings a long, cold tone to signal the breaking dawn. What did you expect to come of this? He asked you wearily. Vengeance? Well, the wolf-bear combo. We got so lucky with some of those cards. That was just the luck run. Even though, yes, it took like 40 minutes to kill the one boss. A new option will be available outside the city walls, okay? And we've never used a hare or beaver. Alright, well, hey, actually beat the prince. Yes, did I cheese it with the deck? I sure the hell did. But that's fine. I can at least say I beat him. I'm gonna stop here. Something else next time. Till then, later guys.